Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami. Welcome to the Christmas Room. This is November 2017. I got a Canon 80D. Let's open it up and see what it's about.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Okay, so there's a new Canon 80D here. B&H photo. My buddy over there sent it to me. He said, here, try it out, play with it, do a little review on it. I said, sure, why not? I've already owned this camera before, and I used it and loved it. And before that, I had the Canon 70D. And now I settled on the GH5, which is what you're watching right now here in the Christmas Room. But so many people go through so much camera pain trying to select a camera, and they watch all kinds of videos to see which one should I buy, and it's like so super frustrating. I know the feeling. I know the pain. This Canon 80D, honestly, if it was a Canon 90D and it had 4K in it, it would be a no-brainer. As a matter of fact, if Canon had 4K and the 90D, and they added electronic shutter, so you'd have silent shutter with everything that the 80D has now, we'd actually have to do a mental check on Canon, because there's something wrong. Because the Canon song is, no 4K for you, and no 4K for you, and no 4K, no 4K, no 4K for you. Or me. That's their policy. You can't find 4K in a Canon camera. And then those that actually have it, it's just there as like a sweet temptation. It's like, okay, we'll put 4K in there. Here, we'll put it in. We know you can't really use it that much. We know most of the computers can't handle it, but we got it. 5D Mark IV and the 1D Mark II. The 1DX Mark II has got 4K, so you can't say we don't give 4K. Oh, baloney. Come on, who are you trying to kid with those lines, you know? Sony, Panasonic, Olympus, Fuji, Pentax. I'm running out of names. They all have 4K. My phone, my little phone that stops and starts this camera, it has 4K. The top-of-the-line camera from Canon. No 4K for you. No, 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 no. So anyway, you go through the pain of trying to select out a camera, and you finally decided that the top thing is you want to grab the camera, and you want to go into any type of a situation. You want good focusing capabilities. You want lots of lenses available, from super high-end lenses like the 50mm f1.2. Where are you going to get something like that? I mean, it's just amazing. So you finally decide, oh, I want to do videos too. Maybe you want to do a video channel. And you go like, I could get so much better quality from that Sony. I could get so much better quality for videos from the Panasonic GH5. Even the GH4. I was just holding it a second ago. Even the GH4. 4K, high quality. But you decide, alas, after all is said and done, the number one priority for you is you want to grab the camera and you want it to focus. Focus, focus. Focus. And you come down to your choice of the Canon 80D. So let's do a little pretend. So this camera just came in. It's brand spanking new. Came in from B&H. It's a loaner. I don't own this one, but I have owned the Canon 80D, and I thought it was absolutely a wonderful, wonderful camera. So let's see what we got here. The 80D. I think this is the body only, but we'll know in a second. So when you open it up, you're going to get some paperwork and a book. And if you get tired of reading this book and this paperwork, they give you another book. Okay, so you get a lot of paper. No paper shortage here. It's 4K shortage, but no paper shortage. Then you've got an incentment to register your camera. So that's all well and good, because Canon has one of the best repair centers of all the people that support cameras. Nikon is equal to them. Okay, so when you send your camera in, it's going to get done right. Try doing that with Sony. Try doing that with Panasonic. You know, they're all trying to get better, but basically compared to Canon and Nikon, they suck. All right, that's just the way it is. All right, so we continue opening the box. And on this side, we have a battery charger, and it's the kind that plugs directly into the wall. You don't need the extra cable. You just pull this out, plug it in, you put the battery here, and it charges, which is what I'm going to do now, because the next video we make together, we're going to do it with the Canon 80D. So we get the charger. Let's save the plastics. It also comes with a walking sign that you hang around your neck that says Canon 80D. So this way, anybody wants to steal the camera from you, they automatically know exactly which model and brand you're using when you use this neck strap. Said that was so clever of Canon to do that. And then, of course, is their battery. And they don't, they meaning Canon, does not chinch out on what battery they give you. It's the same battery that you use in a multiple of the Canon cameras. Plenty of power, and it's one of the few companies that actually give you a cover, so it won't burn a hole in your pants and your leg catches on fire. So we're going to send this into the office to start charging. I'm going to save the plate in here so everything gets returned wonderfully after I get a week or two. And then we get, alas, the Canon 80D body. And it's wrapped very, very well. Canon does things really, really well. Gotta hand it to them. Looks brand new. It comes closed on the LCD, which you can open it. And look at this thing flips all the way around. So you could see from that side if you're standing there. And if I wanted to do a selfie or vlog, I could do it for, and I could see myself. There I be. I'd be right there. Okay, so it's right there and it'll close so that you can't scratch it because it's hiding. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to put a lens on here. And after we put the lens on here, but first the battery has to charge. So we're not going to actually get to fire it up right now, but we're going to fire it up and we're going to make some videos with it, and we're going to take some pictures with it. But I can show you what it looks like with a lens on it, because I have Canon lenses. Yes, I do. I have Canon lenses of my own. Actually, I have a very expensive one. This is a Canon 50mm 1.2L, and if I put that on here, comes with the body cover. I take the body cover off. You can see the mirror in there. Now, if this became a mirrorless camera, there'd be no mirror. And that's why it would be called a mirrorless camera. Duh. Took a lot to figure that one out, right? So you put that on. That's with the 50mm L. And this feels like a proper camera in your hand. The depth of the grip is perfect. So if you're looking at this from a picture point of view to take pictures, what a magnificent camera. You could get a couple of these bodies and hit the ground running, shooting weddings pictures. For video, let's say you want to do it for weddings or you want to do it for YouTube, you're limited with the fact that you don't have 4K. And you know the Canon 4K song, right? They all sing it. We can all sing it together. It goes like this. Ah, no 4K for you. And no 4K for you. And no 4K, no 4K, no 4K for you or me. Now that's the Canon song, all right? But the world is actually going to shake like an earthquake if they come out with a 90D that has 4K in here. And if they put electronic shutter as a choice so you can fire and nobody knows you took a picture. You know, think about it. If they actually did that, okay, all kidding aside, would you buy a Sony? Would you buy an Nikon? Would you buy a Panasonic? Would you buy a Fuji? All those camera companies would take a direct hit. Now, do you know why somebody behind the scenes is not letting 4K slip into this camera? Because it would sink so many camera companies. No one's got a focus system. Nobody's even trying to make a focus system to equal to the dual pixel focus on here. And then if you up the game and go into Canon's professional level of focusing for still images, all in one camera, the only thing you would be missing on this camera is the small size of the Micro Four Thirds, which, just so you can see, this is the GH4, and this is the Canon, okay, 80D. Not a huge amount of difference, all right? So those people that are trying to fool themselves into thinking like Micro Four Thirds means a smaller camera, well, it does. In a lot of instances, it does. But the 80D is not that big. So when they come up with the 85D or the 90D, if they were to add 4K in here, and then maybe on the 7D Mark III, let's say they added, they've got their higher end focusing system in there for people that do birding and sports and stuff like that, which this camera can do, but the 7D Mark II does better. I have to tell you, it does it better. Okay, so if they added, you know, even higher end stuff in the 7D Mark III, it's really gonna knock the air out of some of the other camera companies. It's gonna like knock them on their Aston Martin, okay? So we've unboxed in 2017, November, okay? The month before Christmas, a brand new 80D. And we're gonna go forward with it as if this is now the camera that we chose to start a YouTube channel with. And I'm gonna set it down there and we're gonna set it up and we're gonna make YouTube and see how bad is the quality, or is it much better than a lot of people make it out to be. So that's it, our introduction again and again and again to the Canon 80D. Smile, okay? So that's what we got going. Can't wait to get this 35 millimeter L lens, the F1.4, 35 millimeter F1.4 Mark II. So this is their high end 35 millimeter lens, which goes beautifully with the Canon 80D because it's a crop factor. So that 35 millimeter lens on here with the crop is gonna make an image that looks like it was taken with a 50 millimeter lens, which is one of my favorite numbers, 50, the year of Jubilee, right? All right, so that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. We're just getting rolling with the old, brand spanking new Canon 80D. And remember, no 4K for you and no 4K for me because we're in the Canon 80D. Ooh, that rhymed. Maybe there's a new career going on here. All right, thanks guys. Thanks for having fun with me today. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.
After I closed out the show, Jingles decided he wanted to say hello to everybody. And he wants to know how come for the last couple of episodes, at the end, we haven't had a jingle bell time. So now we do. We've got a jingle bell time. It's a swell time. Just to rock the night away. No, I don't kiss him, but he thinks I do. And you think I do. So I'm a pretty good imitation kisser, aren't I? So this is Jingles, for those of you that haven't met him before. He basically runs the show here. He's in charge of the Christmas room. Actually every room in the house. And at the end of every number of videos, we come up and we get to say hello because actually a lot of people watch just to watch Jingles. They're not here to watch me, are they? Oh, am I boring you? You want to give me a paw? You can give me a paw? You want to give me your paw? Come on. Give me your paw. Don't pretend like you're in there. Give me your paw. That's it. But turn around so everybody can see you. Give me your paw. Okay. Give me your paw. Give me. Give me your paw. Come on. Give me your paw. He's very obedient. Right on the money. Come on. All right. Give me the paw. Jingle bells. Knock, 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 knock. Hey, give me your paw. Come on, baby. Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Jingle bells. Give me your paw. Okay, now it's like, who's going to be more stubborn? Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Jingle bells. Come on, you know what, that's it. That's it, you give me your paw. You know how to do that, right? You give me your paw. Yeah. He's just got to get it into his brain. It's like an upload. So that's it. Me and Jingles are out for today. Catch you guys later. Bye-bye.